la mañana triste y lluviosa, a una joven yo conocí. En su ventana la vi preciosa, como una rosa de mi jardín.
Welcome to Maria's Kitchen. Today we're gonna make gorditas, and I used to do it with my kids when they was little, and they love it. So today I'm gonna make gorditas for my kids and for my family that's here, and they're gonna love it, I think. So here's my daughter Silvia, and she's gonna put all the.
Well, the nice thing about the gorditas is that they're super easy, which if you're like me and you're a working mother, anything that's easy is good. Also, my kids have made these for school projects because it's really simple. So the ingredients are very few items. You need, well, for this she doubled it because we have like everybody in the family here at this moment. They're all staring at me. So what we've got is Maseca, and you have to buy this brand. Sorry, no substitutions allowed. It doesn't turn out the same. So the Maseca, here she used 7 cups of the Maseca. She's got 3 teaspoons of salt and 4 tablespoons of oil. So now Mom is going to add the warm water. It's kind of lukewarm water. And we usually heat it up, or if you have a good sink that has nice warm water.
Can you put a little bit in here, Mina?
Sure.
I'm gonna put a lot more than here. Well, I don't. This is kind of hard because, you know, today I make a lot more than used to. So I think we need more water, Silvia, por favor.
And put some this way.
Yeah. Yeah, they need a lot of water. Yeah, put more water in there. So this is gonna be easy because, you know, this is gonna be there's not too much to do it over here, so. We need a lot more water because we make a lot of gorditas today, so. Let me see.
So while she's doing that, I'm just gonna tell you about what Maseca is. It's actually gluten-free. It's really just a corn meal, and it has a little bit of lime in it. So it's just dry corn meal with a touch of lime. So it's pretty nice because my son has celiac disease, so we can make this and it's not a problem.
Can you put a little bit more water in here?
Normally we don't make this much.
No, but today we have a whole family over here, so. And I have a lot of kids and grandkids, and they all like the gorditas, so. So this is gonna be done pretty soon because there's not too much to do.
Yeah, it looks like it's almost ready.
Yeah, look at this.
So she's just mixing it and kneading it.
And they have to be nice and soft, so it's easy to make the gorditas. And we just put this. I'm gonna show you in a minute. We put beans inside the gorditas. And you can put it in anything you like it in there. Salsa, or eggs, anything you like it in the gordita. So
what I do is I just bake the gordita and then I put stuff on top of it.
Yeah.
I don't bother trying to put it inside.
Yeah.
I can never get it inside.
You know, my grandson, Maurice, he like it just with no beans.
Yeah.
It's just like
plain with butter.
Yep.
Or he'll put cheese on it.
Cheese. A lot of cheese in it.
Yeah, he loves cheese.
Yeah.
I'm sure his triglycerides are quite high.
So when I go visiting my daughter Silvia in California, you know, I always surprise and make gorditas for them in the morning, and they love it. Mm-hmm. Reese and Casey.
So you can see the dough looks a lot different
now.
Yeah. It's still moist, but at the same time.
Put a little bit more water, please. It's almost done.
Yeah, it's almost done. I don't think you need too much more.
But it's easy to do it when it's nice and soft.
Yeah.
See? And now my dishes are a lot of work right now, but it's gonna be easy after all this is done. We just gonna be enjoying it over here. Silvia, can we start now?
Sure.
To make the gorditas?
Okay.
So you can see this nice and soft.
Yeah. And we ended up adding 7.5 cups of water to it. And if it gets dry, you just add a little bit of water just to the top and it'll soften it up. And now she's gonna start making the gorditas.
Okay. So you can make the size you want, you know. They don't have to be little, just regular size. So
what she's doing is basically just putting it from one hand to the other and kind of like punching it in the middle until, I don't know, hers are always round. And then she's gonna add a little bit of beans. These are just refried beans. And then she folds it over and then continues that same kind of patting motion.
See, so the beans don't come out. You have to be real easy over here, you know. It's a gordita.
Okay. So now she's gonna put it on the fire. So we have a comal here, and we put the heat on for medium heat. And now that's gonna cook it. While that's cooking, she's going to make a second one. Now you don't have to put beans in it. You can just make it plain. The plain ones are a lot easier. That's what I make.
And some of my grandsons like it their way too, so.
See, she's making the ones with the beans, but I'm just gonna make a plain one because mine never turned out right. So what I do is I just kind of say, okay, it's about the palm of my hand. It's like a little ball, okay? A little bit bigger than what you would do if you were making a cookie, because a cookie would be about that. So I guess you could say 2 cookies worth.
Yeah, you can do that.
And what I do is I just kind of roll it, and then I do that, but I could never get it like my mother's.
But you kiss like it like that.
You know what, it still tastes the same. It just doesn't look as pretty.
Well, that's room for you, Silvia.
They're gonna see how bad mine looks. Okay, there's mine.
Well, we didn't find a way here, so.
But it still tastes the same.
Well, then my daughter, she just only got to do it. This is almost done, so.
Where are we supposed to put? So the first time when you put it on, you can obviously see that this one is just been put on. After about 2.5 minutes, you're gonna flip it over. And when you flip it over, it should be nice and firm. And you can see how it is right there. Now you're gonna put it on for another 1.5 minutes. And then you flip it one more time, and the last time is gonna be on for just 1 minute. See this one, how it's ready?
and you could tell how it's a little bit brown, that's when it's definitely done, okay? So it should be that way on both sides. And that's when it's done. So 2.5, 1.5, and then 1. And then you just put them over here and put some more on.
These my 3 sons and my granddaughter, they see. So here's Mike.
This is Mike. And Tacy. And this one's for Stuart. And Stevie. He gets the short end of the stick. Oh. That's the one I made. Yeah.
So they send it to me, how do you like? And it works.
Very good.
Good?
They're hot.
See? This is
more delicioso.
That's why I like it, my gorditas, because everybody can have it and enjoy. Gracias por ver a Maria's Kitchen. I see you next time. Prefiero las parrandas, las copas y gozar. Y como me enseñaste la vida a disfrutar, con todos voy y vengo y con nadie soy formal.